This is James Hodder for Rifle TV in association with Matt Prince, Jim Marbauer. I'm in Dublin today. With me, I've got Jamie Kavanagh after his KO victory. How are you feeling, Jamie?
I'm feeling good, yeah. Got the win, got the stoppage, which I knew was there and it was going to come. Just being patient, that was the key.
Yeah. What did you feel worked well for you in there tonight?
Over everything was just my composure and my patience. You know, I don't think this opponent came the actual fight. He just came to be dirty, hired. I think he's actually banned in England from fighting because he's so many disqualifications. Using his head, his elbow, and he used his head tonight, but I didn't let that affect. I knew if I kept myself composed, the stoppage was going to come. I could see the windows. I was just going to keep myself composed and letting it come.
First time fighting in your beloved island in, I don't know how many years. How many years is it since you fought?
No, 7 years, seven, eight years.
Wow. What did it feel like to be back on home soil with in front of your friends, your family and everyone else that you fought full as your career?
It felt great, you know, to look out into the crowd and see the reception that I got. Also coming into the ring and then after getting the victory, the place was very, very loud, you know.
Now, I've tried to get you on RFL TV probably 6 or 7 times. I'm not joking. I've arranged to meet you in London. That never happened through no fault of each other. It just couldn't be done. We've tried to meet in Spain. We missed each other a couple of times. Yeah. Plus at other times at gyms and everything else. But today, get a chance to eat me and I got to talk to you. And I've got to say, while I'm struggling so bad, I've got an abscess on my tooth that came up during the show. So the show just driven me down to the pharmacist to get antibiotics.
Yeah.
I'm in absolute agony, and the first chance to get a proper chat to you, I can't really talk properly.
Yeah, you're in pain.
It's bizarre.
Must be funny.
It is bizarre.
I mean, it's a bit weird. Well, Coogan nipped in there before, and he got the interview before you.
He would do. That's what he's like, Coogan. He's always on the far end getting him exclusive, isn't he? You know what I mean? When can we see out in action next, mate?
It'll be in the new year, I believe. I think MGM and Box Nation are going back here to Ireland. They're doing some big things and I want to be a part of it. So the new year, we're going to rest for the Christmas and the new year. And then we'll be still training in the meantime. I'll be putting myself about in some gyms in London, picking up some sparring. So you'll probably see me around again when I get a chance to do another interview.
Yeah, that'd be good. I mean, you were one of the fights that I missed while I was being taken to the hospital and pharmacist to get some antibiotics. But I watched a bit of it back on the monitor. And I said, you looked in fantastic shape, and you could see that even though he wasn't coming to win, that he was there to stop him and do a job, you know?
Yeah, that was an important thing as well, was picking up the stoppage.
Looking good, I suppose, as well, in front of your home crowd.
Of course, yeah, it's my first fight home, it's my homecoming, so I'm happy overall the way it went.
Where'd you go from here?
As I said, we'll sit down with the team in the new year, and we want to hopefully pick up an international belt in the new year. If we can do so around being here in my hometown, which that would be great, because also like the supporters here, if we can get Box Nation to come back regularly, we have both things, which is the key, and it's just up to me putting on the performances.
Listen, congratulations on a good win. So it's good to see you back out in
Thank
action,
you.
Mate.
And thanks,
hopefully next time we meet up, I don't look like Elephant Man. So yeah, I'll catch you again real soon. Thank you, Jamie.
Thanks.